Airmen Safety Professionals and Unit Safety Representatives, I'm excited today to share a development in Air Force safety. Since the first flight with the Wright brothers, airmen have relied on safety rules and regulations. Here's a copy from 1944, published by the War Department under the command of General Hap Arnold. Our regulations have changed substantially since then. With the enactment of the Occupational Safety and Health Act of 1970, which formed OSHA, and subsequent executive orders, safety regulations exploded. Our main volume, AFI 91203, stands at 969 pages today. And while many of the parts of the AFI work well, other chapters are duplicative and lack a simple clarity of this book. So what do we need to do to update and produce an instruction in everyone's best interest? What's going to change? First, the duplications will be removed. Chapters will be merged and simplified where possible. Then, as beneficial to the reader, OSHA references will be cited. And as it's best not to copy federal law time after time, which is how we got to nearly 1,000 pages, major portions will instead be referenced. This technique lends itself to better accuracy and a military fluency with federal law we've somehow lost with this. The change will also mean training. Training for the safety professionals, unit safety representatives, and supervisors at forums such as the Unit Safety Representative Training and Supervisor Safety Training. Training will also include how to read a Code of Federal Regulations, or CFR, and how to see if the paragraph is even applicable. The change will mean a better informed Air Force. When federal law makes an engineering practice safer or changes the personal protective equipment required for a hazardous task, we will no longer wait for the trickle-down of regulations that take years to take effect on the flight line or weapon storage area. With the change, this common occurrence will be a simple notice to both safety professionals and the affected career fields. How can you help with the transition? Begin by familiarizing yourself with parts of 29 CFR 1910 for general industry or 1926 for construction, the ones most applicable to you and your mission. These are easily accessed at OSHA.gov. You don't have to read it all at first. Start with the subjects you most commonly work with and review the letters of interpretation and applicable exceptions. Also, use and cite federal regulations during inspections, both annual and spot inspections. Referencing federal law also helps your local senior leadership with the language. After a tough OSHA inspection, senior leaders who are more familiar with how federal law and safety work together are best prepared for a successful outbrief. Finally, as our safety rules change, let's not forget that compliance does not equate to safe. As an Air Force, we were born to go above and beyond. We will keep our many programs that exceed federal law and make workplaces safer for airmen. Our airmen deserve our very best and a safe place to perform our most trusted of missions. I'm proud to serve with you. Thank you for what you do every day for airmen and for our nation.